Hello guys, welcome to my channel, Math is Fine. Okay, this is Civil Service Examination Reviewer in Mathematics Part 2A. Okay, this means that I already uploaded a Part 1, A, B, and C. Okay, sa mga hindi pa nakapanood doon, okay, ilalagay ko ang link sa description box below. Okay, please watch it and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Please like and share. Okay, I am Cheryl M. Esguera, a mathematics teacher by profession and a mathematics coach, as well as I am the room examiner in the civil service examination. Okay, testing center is Dasmariñas City. So, stay tuned. Okay guys, ito na yung first question natin. If A is an even integer and B is an odd integer, which of the following is not an even integer? Okay, pakipost na muna tong video, then sagutan nyo muna. I will give you the answer afterwards. Okay, the correct answer is letter C, 5A minus 3B. Okay, paano natin nakuha yung sagot na yan? Okay, dito ay gumamit ako ng trial and error. Okay, let A is equal to 2, the smallest even integer, and B is equal to 1, the smallest odd integer. So, papalitan lang natin yung bawat options dyan. Papalitan yung A, papalitan natin ng 2, yung B, papalitan natin ng 1. We're going to substitute it. Okay, 2a plus b times 2b, that is equal to 2 times 2 plus 1 times 2 times 1. So 2 times 2, the answer is 4, plus 1 times 2 times 1, the answer is 2. So 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. Basically, letter A is not the answer. Okay, for letter B, 5a plus 2b, okay, that is 5 times 2 is equal to 10, 2 plus 2 times 1 is equal to 2, 10 plus 2 is equal to 12. Okay, again, obviously, letter B is not the correct answer. Okay, for option letter C, 5A minus 3B, okay, 5 times A is equal to 2, 5 times 2 is 10, minus 3 times 1 is 3. 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. So, sa option letter C, ito yung lumabas na not even integer. Okay, sa letter D naman tayo, check natin. Okay, 3b plus 2a plus b, that is 3 times 1 plus 2 times 2 plus 1. Okay, that is 3 plus 5, the answer is equal to 8. So, obviously, the correct answer is letter C. Okay, hello guys, ito yung question number 2 natin. If 4x is equal to 10 and 6y is equal to 12, what is 24xy? Okay. Pause nyo muna itong video, then ibibigay kong sagot pagkatapos. Okay, the correct answer is 120. Paano natin nakuha yung 120? So here, 4x is equal to 10. Okay, kailangan natin kukunin yung value ng x. So, paano natin makuha yung value ng x? Ma-eliminate itong 4 dito na katabi niya by dividing 4 both sides of the equation. So, pag dinivide natin ng 4 yan, x na lang natitira. Okay, that is x is equal to 5 halves. Paano naman natin yung nakuha yung 5 halves? Okay, yung 10 over 4, na-reduce lang natin siya sa lowest term. Okay, 10 divided by 2, the answer is 5. 4 divided by 2, the answer is equal to 2. Kaya, 5 halves. Then, next is, kukunin natin yung value ng y. Okay, meron tayong equation sa taas. Here, 6y is equal to 12. Okay, 6y is equal to 12. To get the value of y, okay, we should eliminate 6 here. Paano natin ma-eliminate? Okay, we should divide 6 both sides of the equation. Okay, mag-divide lang tayo ng 6. So, 6 divided by 6, the answer is 1, or y na lang yung natitira natin dyan. Then, 12 divided by 6, the answer is 2. So, y is equal to 2. Then, to get the value of 24xy, substitute lang natin yung value ng x natin at saka yung value ng y. So, 24 times 5 halves times 2. So, the answer is 240 divided by 2. that is equal to 120. Okay, ito lang yung way paano natin kukunin yung sagot sa number 2. Okay guys, ito naman yung item number 3 natin, solve for x and y. Okay, for our first equation, second equation, and our option. Okay, can you pause it first before I'm going to give you the correct answer? Okay, the correct answer is letter D, x is equal to 1, and y is equal to negative 1. Okay, paano natin nakuha yan? Okay, we're going to solve this one. We're going to eliminate one of the variables, either x and y. Pero dito, sa example na ito, ang ma-eliminate natin kaagad-agad is yung y. But because this is plus y and minus y, okay, positive, negative, if we're going to combine, we're going to subtract positive 1 minus negative 1, the answer is 0. So, ang y dito ay makanceled natin. So, natitira natin sa left side ay 5x, sa right side naman ay 5. Paano na ko yung 5x? That is 3 plus 2 is equal to 5, then copy x, then sa other side naman is 2 plus 3, that is equal to 5. So, to get the value of 5, we're going to divide 5 both sides of the equation. So, na-cancel na natin ang 5 dito. X is equal to 1. So, this is the value of x. Okay, anong gagawin natin sa value ng x? Okay, gagamitin natin ito. Pwede natin i-substitute dito sa first or the second equation natin. So, first, gagamitin muna natin yung first equation. So, 3x plus y is equal to 2. We're going to substitute the value of x. Okay, the value of x is equal to 1. Ang nangyari ay 3 times 1 plus y is equal to 2. Okay, 3 times 1, the answer is equal to 3. Then just copy plus y equals 2. Then to get the value of y, kailangan nating alisin itong 3 na nandito sa right side. Paano natin ito maalis? Okay, itatranspose lang natin to the other side of the equation. Kung ito ay positive, pagdating sa other equation natin ay sa kabila ay negative. So, nangyari dito ay nagiging y is equal to 2 minus 3. So, 2 minus 3, that is equal to negative 1. Okay, y is equal to negative 1. Ito yung way paano natin kukunin yung sagot sa item number 3. Okay, for item number 4, in an equilateral triangle XYZ, what is the length of line XY if line YZ is 6 mm? And line XZ is also 6 mm. Okay, pause it first, find your answer, then I will give you the answer afterwards. Okay, the correct answer is letter A, 6 mm. How we get the correct answer? Okay, when we say equilateral triangle, that is a kind of triangle having three sides equal. So, obviously, XY is also 6 mm. Okay, for number 5, solve for AC in the diagram below. Okay, can you pause the video first, then I will give you the answer afterwards. Okay, the correct answer is letter B, 17. How we get 17? Okay, we use the Pythagorean theorem. Okay, what is Pythagorean theorem? That is C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. So, here, if our reference point is A, then the opposite side is A. Small letter A at the opposite. Then here is our adjacent side. This is B, and this is our hypotenuse. This is C. So, if we're going to find C, AC is on the C side. So, C squared is equal to A squared plus B squared. Okay, we're going to square. Get the square root of A squared plus B squared. Okay, we're going to substitute the value of A, which is equal to 15 squared plus value for B is 8, then squared. So, 15 squared is equal to 225 plus 8 squared, that is equal to 64. So, to find the value of C, okay, we're going to extract the square root of 289. Okay, how we get 289? That is come from 225 plus 64. So, the square root of 289 is equal to 17. Okay, paano natin ako yung 17? Okay, the square root of 289. Because 17 times 17, the answer is equal to 289. So, that's the way how we're going to get the answer for number 5 and number 4. Thank you. Okay, this is our problem for item number 6. Okay, read it first, then answer, then pause the video. Okay, we'll give you the answer afterwards. Okay, the correct answer is equal to 96. How we get 96? Okay, we have 3 steps. Step 1, get the total. Okay, ano yung total na sinasabi dito? Ito yung 90 times 5. Saan galing yung 90? Dito sa average of 90. Tapos yung 5, ito yung 4 subjects here. Then yung next subject, that is equal to 5 subjects. So, 19 times 5 is equal to 450. Okay, step 2, add the given 4 grades. Okay, add lang natin yon. 87 plus 93 plus 89 plus 85, that is equal to 354. Then step 3, subtract step 1 and step 2. Okay, that is 450 minus 354, that is equal to 96. Okay, ito yung 96 dito. Ito na yung pinaka-final answer natin. Okay, this is the grade for the next subject. Okay, here is our next item, number 7. Okay, pause the video first, then read the problem, then answer. Then afterwards, I will give you the correct answer. Okay, the correct answer is 4.49%. Paano natin nakuha yan? Okay, meron tayong formula. I is equal to PRT. Ano yung I? That is interest. P, principal. R is rate. And T is the time. So, ang kailangan natin dito sa ating problem is the rate of interest. Okay, not the interest alone because we have here the interest, 80 pesos. So, gagawa tayo ng formula for the rate. Okay, from that formula, gagawa tayo na magdi-derive tayo ng other formula for rate. Okay, dito, ang kailangan natin mawala is yung P at saka T. Paano natin iwawala yan? Kailangan lang natin mag-divide both sides of the equation by P over T. So, makancel na natin yan. So, nandun na yung PT sa other side. Ang nasa left, right side na natin ay R na lang. Okay, then pwede natin balikta rin yan. Okay, this is our formula. How we're going to find the rate of interest. Okay, rate of interest is equal to interest over principal times time. Okay, yung time natin dito is in years. So, mag-substitute lang tayo doon sa ating formula. Okay. Ang interest natin ay 80 over, ang principal natin ay 10,000, at saka yung time natin ay 0.178. Saan galing itong 0.178? Okay, galing yan dito. Kuna-convert lang natin yung 65 days to a year. So, to convert that one, gagawa lang tayo ng ganyang equation. Okay, 65 days times 1 year over 365. Okay, bakit nasa ilalim ang 365 para matanggal natin yung days dito? So, natitira natin sa taas ay 65 year divided by 365. So, if we're going to divide that one, ang answer natin dyan ay 0.178 year. Okay, yun yung minumultiply natin dito. Then, just multiply 10,000 times 0.178. Okay, may sagot tayong nakuha dyan na 80 over 1,780. So, if we're going to divide that one, our answer is 0.0449. Then, this is in decimal. To change decimal to percent, since the rate is in percent, okay, to change natin to into percent, just move the decimal point 2 places going to the right. Okay, this 1, 2, kaya meron tayong sagot na 4.49%. Okay, this is the way how we're going to get the correct answer. Okay, this is for our next problem, item number 8. Pause this video first, then read the problem, then answer. Then I will give you the answer afterwards. Okay, the correct answer is letter B, 2 days. How we get 2 days? Okay, meron tayo ditong equation na nagawa. Okay, paano natin nakuha yung 1 over 6 plus 1 third plus 1 over x? So, ang 1 here dito, sinasabi itong dito a job. Okay, 1 job in 6 days. Okay, that is 1 over 6 plus yung B, that's the same job. The same job in 3 days. Okay, that is also 1 over 3. Then, 2 of them working together. Okay, that is 1 over x. So, to get the answer, we're going to solve this item first at the left side. So, this is 1 sixth plus 1 third. Okay, this is adding the similar fraction. Meron akong video na ganito. Okay, lalagay ko yung link sa description box below. Adding the similar fractions. Okay, to add this, okay, ito yung pinaka-shortcut dito. 1 times 3, the answer is equal to 3. 6 times 1, the answer is equal to 6. And 6 times 3, the answer is equal to 18. Then just copy is equal to 1 over x. Then add the numerators. 3 plus 6, the answer is equal to 9 over 18 is equal to 1 over x. Then just reduce 9 over 18 to its lowest term. 9 divided by 9, the answer is equal to 1. 18 divided by 9, the answer is equal to 2. So 9 over 18, lowest term is 1 half, is equal to 1 over x. Okay, to get the value of x, just cross multiply. 1 times x, the answer is equal to x. And 2 times 1, the answer is equal to 2. So we get the correct answer, x is equal to 2. Okay, this is the way how we get the correct answer. Okay, for item number 9, read the question first, then answer. Pause this video before I'm going to give you the correct answer. Okay, the correct answer is equal to A, 46. How we get 46? Okay, this problem is all about the measures of central tendency. So we have the mean, median, and the mode. Okay, here is the median. How are we going to get the median? Okay, step 1 is arrange the given numbers in ascending order. So, galing sa maliit na number, arrange lang natin siya pataas from 42 papuntang 50. Okay, galing to sa given numbers natin. Arrange lang natin, hanapin lang natin pinakamaliit. Then, sunod-sunod yun pataas natin. Then, after that is look at the middle number. Okay, bilangin lang natin kung ilan yung numbers natin, elements natin. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, we have an even elements. So, hindi natin makikita kaagad kung ano yung pinakagitna noon. So, dito ay 1, 2, 3. So, ang pinakagitna natin itong 45 at saka yung 47. Itong dalawa. Okay, 1, 2, 3 sa left side, 4, tatlo din sa right side. So, to find the, if there is none, so, two numbers, take two numbers at the middle, then find the arithmetic mean or the average. Okay, ito yung hanapin natin. So, ang gagawin natin dito is 45 plus 47, the answer is equal to 92, then just divide it by 2. The answer is equal to 46. Or kahit dito, pwede nyo na makita eh. 45, 47, so ang gitna niya ng dalawa ay 46. So, ito yung way paano natin kukunin yung sagot sa number 9. Okay, this is our last item, number 10. Read it first, pause the video, then answer. Then I will give you the answer afterwards. Okay, the correct answer is letter D, 60. How do we get 60? Okay, just simply add the parts in the ratio. Okay, pag ganito yung tanong, i-add mo lang itong parts na ito. Okay, that is equal to 2 plus 3 plus 4, that is equal to 9. Okay, anong gagawin mo sa 9 na to? Okay, step 2, divide the sum by the answer in step 1. Okay, anong sum na sinasabi dito? Ito yung nasa problem natin. The sum of 270 is to be divided among the x, y, and z. Okay, just divide 270 divided by 9. Okay, our answer is 30. We get the answer of 30. Anong gagawin natin sa 30 na yan? Multiply step 2 to its part in the ratio. Okay, multiplyan mo lang to, bawat isa dito na by 30. So, ang pagbibigyan niyan is si x, y, and z. Ibig sabihin si x ay 2 parts, si y ay 3 parts, and si z is 4 parts. So, just multiply. Okay, 2 times 30, the answer is equal to 60. Ito ay para kay x. Okay, next is, sa kay y is equal to 3 times 30, that is equal to 90. And si z ay 4 times 30, that is equal to 120. Okay, pag itotal natin yung tatlo na yan, that is equal to 270. Okay, tama siya dun sa ating problem. Okay, balikan na natin yung tanong natin. How much will x receive? Okay, si x ang tinatanong, so hindi natin kailangan yung sagot kay y at sa kay z. So, ang ating answer ay equal to 60. Okay, this is the way how we're going to get the answer to problem number 10. So, sana may natutunan kayo sa video yung in-upload ko ngayon. Okay, thank you for watching. And sa hindi pa nakapag-subscribe sa channel na ito, please subscribe. And don't forget to click the notification bell so that pag mag-upload ako ng next video ko, ay man-notified kayo. Okay, thank you!